The IFC Green plugin allows you to examine the environmental impact of your project. The plugin itself consists of three buttons in the main interface. Some of the functionalities can be found in the context menu, right mouse button. We will also use measurements taken in the IMVision measurement tab. To be able to work with our model, we need to feed it with data. The plugin provides such a sample database during installation. It can be found on our computer in Documents. Before uploading it to the program, let's see what it looks like. We can supplement this database with our own data. And here, for example, we will insert an additional item into the database. It is important that all required columns are completed. That is why some fields just contain X. We can also enter additional columns with information here. Here we will enter values for this additional information. This changed database can now be saved under a different name. We close the database Excel file and return to the program to be able to use it. The moment we have the model open, we can import the database. We go to Documents and select the original database or the extended one from where it was saved. Once the database is uploaded, we can proceed to entering items and counting values. We select one of the elements and click on IFC Green. We can see that the database of available items is displayed, including the item we just added. We see that the element selected on the model is an asphalt road. It is worth paying attention to the unit for this item. Here we see square meters, which means that for this element, we will convert values to square meters, so we will measure the area of the element. After entering this item, we see that new data has appeared in the element. Here we have a whole set of identification and reference data entered for this element. Once we have entered reference data into the elements, we still need to measure them. In the case of the street, it will be the area because the reference unit of the assigned data is square meters. We can now go to the Measurement tab, select the appropriate tool, and take the measurement. When this measurement appears on an element, a context menu will be displayed when you right-click. We choose Measurement. We can see that the quantity has been added as a parameter and the individual indicators have been recalculated. Now we select four objects, benches, and then select IFC Green to assign data from the database to them. We see that the items in our database have different units. Cubic meters, conversion to cubic capacity, square meters, area, meters, lengths, or U, conversion to a single occurrence of an object. We use the bench selection. For objects like these benches, with the unit units, we no longer need to measure. We can see that each bench already has information, for example, about its carbon footprint, total carbon dioxide. Once we have dimensioned the roadway, example benches, let's see an element that will be converted according to material to volume. So, for example, let's select the walls of a kiosk. For this purpose, we have selected all the walls in this project. Now we can assign them any of the positions with one click. Let it be just a Poroton brick. and that is how it is defined here. The next step is to measure the elements. Therefore, we select these elements, that is, the walls. We go to the Measurement tab and select the volume. We add Measurement. As we continue our work, we measure further elements. And when all of them are defined by positions from the database and measured, we can proceed to creating the report. We are able to show all the information collected in it. There isn't much of it here, but let's try to highlight these elements: four benches, roadway, and walls. Once we have a selection in the model, we go to the report and choose the selected option. Next, we indicate that we want to receive information about individual indicators in the report, such as the total carbon footprint, total water footprint, budget, or any other available information such as the producer added to the table. When we go to the Summary tab, we see that we have a division into groups by elements. That is because we have a tag here at the element type level. In each of the columns, we have information of interest to us that we wanted to show. We can also create a color gradient by the minimum and maximum parameter value. The received report can be saved as an Excel document. We get a table like this. In addition to all this information, we also have links to the objects. We can, therefore, quickly find such an element. After clicking on such a link to an object in Excel, we will see the indicated element in the model. We can also save the file in the BVF format so that we can continue working later. That is, assign further data about the elements and their measurements, and prepare a summary final report.